But you have a good gang of boys on.
Aye, they're not bad, to be fair to them. Like, now, them boys,
but works,
I would have been lost without them boys this year now. Like,
workers are hard to get.
Oh, they are, big time. Like, them boys is the more all-nighters and weekend work this year than we had done probably the last 3 years put together. You know, there are many a morning, Garth, I get out of my bed thinking, what's this all about?
Yeah.
And, you know, them boys, would I do it for somebody else? I don't know. You know, so you're really lucky that them boys is in the yard every morning.
But, you know, I suppose we like to sit down and chat to every man and woman about, you know, their business and what they're doing. But business isn't easy.
No.
And, you know, you'll have your good people and you'll have your bad people. You'll have your cracking staff and you'll have had your trouble staff.
Well, I think, you know, I'm happy with my boys. Don't get me wrong, there are days they probably maybe think that I'm no, my mood's maybe not the best, but, you know, there more goes on in this job than sitting in here or blowing grass up a spit. You know, there's, and the temper's maybe just not the best all the time, but we are fairly, between customers and staff, like we have good customers and we have good staff, it's half the ball.
Oh, I get it, Ma.
I'll get you a knife.
That man needs a wee bottle of Coke, hey?
No, it's tough, hey. No, it's your business. They're mayor tape that just stand on it. The head and shoe, wasn't it?
Oh, aye, there is. What I always find in life, people that run business understand business.
No, aye, yep, that's right.
And, yeah. You know, and people that pass all the past judgmental comments or say all the things that they're not really running a business.
I had a customer the other day. I was actually in his yard for an invoice, and we were talking, and that's what he said. He says, you know, he says, you give your business over. There's a lot of boys out there. He says, 10 days, not over there.
Well, you know, and I always find when I'm chatting to people who run businesses, I always have better conversations with them because they know what it's like to have poison run through a team, or they know what it's like that someone has maybe stole something or took something they shouldn't have taken. And we all have that.
And you know this.
And every business has it.
Yep.
Or they know what it's like. You know, I know what it's like to receive a letter in that some of your customers, maybe the wholesale to you, has gone to the wall and you're not going to get paid.
Here, that's exactly right. That's exactly, and that's what it's all about, you know.
And you try to protect your people from that, but then sometimes I think you're just best being honest with your people and saying, look, I would just go in and say, look, I'm grumpy today. And you just hope they understand.
You know, there's plenty of nights I'm sitting at the kitchen table 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning with a cup of tea, staring at it probably at the wall, to be honest with you. Wondering, how am I going to get this week through?
Here, I worked at a contractor years ago, and I can tell you, there's many a night I know for a fact, he was out walking the yard through the night because he couldn't settle himself.
During the first cup was, I was hell.
You were under pressure.
No, first cup.
But you know, but that's something else that needs to be touched on, mental health.
Yep.
You know, you're pushing on, you're asking your boys to push on through the night. Morale can go down.
And big time, and look, that's something that you guys do.
That's maybe why there's so much pub talk.
Well, it probably is. You know, they touch on quite a lot, you know, and to be fair, the mental health thing, anybody that hasn't come through it doesn't know anything about it, so therefore it's a different light to them, you know. But you do need a team of good men around you. You need a good team of everybody around you to pull you through them days where you start to dip, you know. You know, like every day is not like this here, the sun's shining and nice crops, and you sitting in here in a bit of crack, like, you know. It's
eating a bag of crisps and
eating a bag of crisps. Even though he was to bring me sandwiches and he forgot, but anyway.
Start with the crisps
first. With the crisps.
But no, and you're right, and I think it takes a very brave people to be honest.
Oh, it does.
And, you know, whilst not everybody needs to know everything in your life. No. You need to keep a certain amount.
Well, you didn't hide everything either.
No. Absolutely. If you're under pressure, it's good to talk. And I noticed there, I don't know if you've seen it on TikTok or any of them things, but you know, wee Paddy, the Scouser, the boxer?
Yeah.
Did you see his speech?
Yeah.
And I thought, that hit a nerve with me.
Yeah.
And he'd won a fight, like a title fight, and he walked out of the ring in tears.
Yeah.
It meant nothing to him.
Aye.
But he used his medium. You know, he used his publicity, right, and he made it all about his friend and a wee sick kid.
Yep.
And he made it all about, and I thought...
Everybody, Gareth, in there, in my opinion, you know, has something to niggle them, you know, or something that's very important to them, or something to think on, something that makes us all want to probably cry, you know, as much as Nez wants to admit it, but everybody has their own thing out there, you know. Should it be work, should it be... health, should it be whatever, you know.
Well, maybe if you bought John Deere's, that would all disappear.
I'll sort my boiler, wouldn't it?
Well, I'm not saying I would.
They were on me yesterday, you know.
I woke up on Friday morning at 4 a.m. to a message that one of my friends back home had killed himself. This is 5 hours before me weighing. So, Ricky, lad, that's for you. But, there's a stigma in this world that men can't talk. Listen, if you're a man and you've got weight on your shoulders and you think the only way you can solve it's by killing yourself, please speak to someone. Speak to anyone. People would rather, I know I'd rather be made cry on your shoulder than go to his funeral next week. So please, let's get rid of this stigma and men start talking.
Beautiful words, Paddy, and rest in peace to your friend.